Hey, Sifu Jason here with Sifu Josh as well, and we're happy to be here at Greenville Academy of Martial Arts. And before we get started in the content, let's make sure you exercise your finger, do the right thing, click the like and subscribe button. Exactly. It doesn't take a lot of special talent, but remember, if you don't do it, something terrible is going to happen to you. In this case, you're going to do your laundry, and you're going to leave the clothes in the washer. You're not going to put them in the dryer fast enough. They're going to sit there and fester in their dampness, and they're going to smell really bad. And so then you have to rewash them, and probably rewash them again. And so if you do it, something like that. So and you're still going to stink, because you're still going to smell it. All right. On to the content. Make sure you do the right thing. Biggest mistake in Wing Chun, there's a lot of them, but we're going to zero in on something that's really impacting Wing Chun and negatively. If, like, you're doing something with accounting and you make a mistake, your numbers are off and so forth. You do something wrong with Wing Chun being a combat art, something's wrong with your face. So we want to make sure you keep yourself as safe as possible. So here we go. It's a misapprehension that training drills and fighting tactics and the way you fight are just one and the same. So a lot of Wing Chun students who've never been in fights come into Wing Chun, get into this great system, and are not told, or maybe the instructors don't know. It can be either or, but they think some of the training drills they're doing, let's say Lap Chow. So we're doing a Lap Chow drill, and they're spending a lot of time being very exact with this drill, and they think that this drill is going to be fighting. Now, a lot of people you spend a lot of time doing that, doing Chi Sao. So here we are doing Chi Sao, and I'm doing this, and I'm like, oh, I got him here, I'm doing this. And we're not gonna be in contact with people in this type of environment. So Wing Chun is not the training drills. Wing Chun is the forms, which is giving us the structural foundation of the applications, which are limited only by our need and our imagination. That's a line I stole from my Sifu, Tony Massengill. The forms are the foundation of the system. And then you have your footwork and striking tools. You have to practice those just as much as like a Muay Thai guy or a boxer practices their basic tools. Then we have training drills. Any training drill, anything you're doing is a training drill. And then you have fight tactics. So, what happens is that people can start thinking this, you know, Lap Chow drill, or we're doing this drill, and they spend so much time learning how to do this properly that they forget that this drill, if Wing Chun is forms, footwork, striking tools, training drills, fight tactics, training drills are one-fifth of what you're doing, and so any drill you're going to do is going to take up valuable training time. And instead of like working and hitting, working pads and so forth, they spend so much time doing Lap Chow, they do Pak Chow drill, they do Chi Sao, and they spend so much time getting good at that, and they get hyper technical with it. But those drills don't have a lot of fight transfer. And that's really where the problem is. For example, let's take the middle of the Sultan Tao form, where after you come out of Pak Chow, you're coming in here. Right, so you get these short little motions right here, toss out. Now let me put Josh in that. We call this defense drill. Now what Josh wants to get good at here is learning how to pick off punches. Now initially, I'm not gonna have him moving, but see how he's just doing what we call a basic box. He's defending my left with his right, he's defending my right with his left. Not because he always has to do that, but because for his first training, it's the best way to go. I'll keep things simple for him. He's not chasing hands around. He's just using, now you look at the motion. He's using this motion right here to catch the middle. He's using this motion there to catch the corner. And he's got a fence in, which most people want to swing, and I'll face the camera here. They want to swing it this way. That's a tough punch to catch. I think probably the I would say largest mistake that I see is that Wing Chun guys are going, well, I punch scientifically, and this is, you know, the work of a barbarian or whatever it is, and they become kind of a martial snob. But the punch, this punch is actually harder to catch than you think it is, because this punch, that kind of right looping right cross that a lot of people just kind of throw naturally, it's just a bit too compact to really get a tan sao with any real power on it. And you can, of course, you can't use a bong sao. A bu sao doesn't really work against it. It's a very weird angle. And so it takes a while to catch it. And one of the best ways to deal with it is to prevent it, right? It's not to have to defend against it. So when he puts his fence up, he's naturally blocking that line, so I have to go around the fence, which allows him to catch this shot. Now the other one is a hook. He's catching this with a short straight line. If you look at what he's doing, I'm not going to get too technical here, but and then in the middle, it's forcing me in the middle, but it's forcing me around the corner. So this is a drill that has more practical, tactical application ability than, say, lap size drill. And I would suggest, and that's what we do here, practice things more because you have valuable time. Some guy commented on one of our videos before. He said that he practices like 12 hours a day. And I'm like, 12 hours a day? Okay. None of us have unlimited amount of time and resources. So therefore, the time and resources that we put into our training needs to be very well thought out. My suggestion is to do drills like this that are more combat applicable than, say, a drill that is going to be very good against other Wing Chun guys and give you a false sense of security. That's why you see some people coming out and they're trying to fight a boxer or an MMA guy, and they're training like they try to apply a system that works in their kun against other Wing Chun guys, but not picking off the shots. Now, let's say if I open this up a bit and I'm going to move around a little bit with Josh, okay? And he's just catching these shots. Now, I don't have any gloves on. Now, look at, he was stepping in a punch. He did a just out. He didn't know what I was going to do. But the reason he punched, he still jammed the line. So his hands are in position to catch the punches that I'm going to be throwing. Okay? And that is a much more combat effective drill. It's, you know, again, it's got to be trained so you don't, because it's natural for him to start chasing hands. It's natural for him to shoot out there or leave himself wide open. It's natural for him to overcommit, right, and drop that hand and that kind of thing so he can get faked and so forth. Yeah, so those are the things he has to be trained for, and he needs good partners to be training with it so that he's not getting somebody trying to clobber him. I mean, you wouldn't go into a gym, be really fat and out of shape, and try to go find a personal trainer, and the personal trainer comes up, hey, fat boy, I'm going to be your trainer. And he's like, get your fat butt over here. And then, puts like, have you ever squatted before? Well, no, I've got bad knees. Well, I'm going to make you tough. And he put like 400 pounds in a bar and kill you. That would be a bad personal trainer. Well, it's a bad coach, gym instructor that just sends you out there and beats the crap out of you and tells you, it's going to make you tougher. That's nonsense. You build people up. And so what we do here with a drill like the fence drill is you build guys up. And up to the point where we can give them a mouthpiece and have them out there with my boxers and so forth. And they're reasonably trying to hit them. I mean, you don't turn it into a fight, but you can put more pressure on him so he gets used to, and this is the key, he gets used to seeing real punches coming at him. Because if the only time you've ever had real punches come at you is when they're really coming at you, you've got yourself a significant problem, right? You're not going to rise to the level of your challenge. You're going to conform to the level of your discipline. You're not going to do under pressure something you've never done in the school. You're just not going to be better under pressure than you are when you're training. So that's it. That's a garden variety rule. Maybe there's some dude that can do that every now and then, but that's not something you want to bank on. Again, that's like going out and just planning to get someplace in 5 minutes because you're going to run every traffic light. Now, so if you take this and you look at the form, just these things are in the forms, right? Here it's right in the form. So I'm doing this in the form. All you're doing is using it in a way that's more applicable to live combat. If you don't do that, you have the form, but you can't use it for fighting, that's an indication that the training drills you're using and the training environment you've got is not conducive with reality. And reality always gets the last word, right? So if you're running east looking for a sunset, you've got yourself a foundational problem. And that's the issue earlier. I mean, off camera, we were talking about, having a car. You get this awesome car, and it's, sitting in your garage. It's just gorgeous, but you can't drive a stick. You don't have a car. You have, what are we doing, an ornament? Is that what you're saying? Okay, thank you. Couldn't remember. So I'm not really that kind. Or if you try to drive my truck, and my truck is awesome, and I try to race it in a NASCAR, isn't going to work. You can off-road with that sucker. It still look good, but seriously. You've got a tool, and Wing Chun is giving you an incredible tool. And you're doing the forms, you're building the weapon that you are, and you have to learn to use it. And so the best way to do that, the safest way to do that, is in training drills. If you get training drills that are just too hyper-technical and they only work against other Wing Chun guys, then what you're going to have is you're going to have a kind of a dichotomy there where what you're really good at is being in the school. Now that's fun. If you want to do that, that's fine. But that's why you're seeing a breakdown in performance between some Wing Chun people who've been training for years and they should have better self-defense skills. And it's just because they're using drills that are giving them muscle memory and tactical memory that isn't conducive and isn't coherent to the facts of reality. Okay, so that would be my big thing. We just gave you sort of one drill to isolate that for you so you could see it. And keep thinking about that key, because that's important, because what you do in training is going to determine what you do under pressure. And that's the key for the whole thing, application. So, Sifu Jason here, Sifu Josh, and we bid you farewell. Make sure, again, you click the like and subscribe button. Check us out, Greenville Academy Online. Again, yeah, click the button, or stinky, soggy clothes. Check us out online, greenvilleacademy.com. And you know, again, if you do get a chance, we are also on Facebook, Greenville Academy on Facebook, and we also have Academy JKD and Wing Chun on Facebook too for all of you out of towners. Check them out.